final segment of the show for today. The topic is prejudice and racism at the 21st century, and Dr. Kelly Sanford has given us excellent information relative to some classical views of prejudice. And now I think, Dr. Sanford, we wish to start by at least making some statements, then get into racism, which is a different kind of thing that we've been dealing with.
Absolutely, and we started the segment off just to reiterate a little bit that prejudice is a favorable or unfavorable type of an action that a person might act toward another without any warrant, without any prior knowledge of that individual. And sometimes this is caught into the history of a society. And of course, here in America, we experienced 244 years of enslavement, 81 years of Jim Crow laws that led into Reconstruction that was supposed to help better situations. And of course, it didn't. Those laws that were there really impacted future generations of people to look in a very prejudicial, discriminatory way toward others, that led into the Civil Rights Movement, that then led into as students, as you asked in the last segment, born in the 90s, and somewhat are unfamiliar with what happened in those prior hundreds of years that we've lived in America with, much longer than we've lived without. You see, and that's one of the major problems is why we have to still have this conversation. I think if we look at the NAACP or the Urban League, and if you were to ask those leaders if there's a need, they would probably say, well, yeah, we would just love to just dismantle NAACP if there weren't prejudice and discrimination that still exists. But there is. And so therefore, we want to move from understanding this unfavorable type of action toward others based on how a person might look or their gender and their so-called ethnic group that they might belong to. And understand that that moves into the act of racism, where someone physically gives you another type of treatment just based on how one might look. And this is what we have to deal with. We have a local scholar who just recently came to speak at Tennessee State University by the name of Mr. Tim Wise. And like the other book that I just mentioned, Black Like Me, he has a book that is entitled White Like Me. And he talks about the privilege that you have by being a part of the majority group. And he came to Tennessee State University to talk with a large mixed freshman class and those that knew about it and went. And he gives us very good commentary on how prejudice, racism still exists here in the 21st century. And he goes out and he does presentations on that. And I wanted to cite him because he does an excellent job of that. And it goes back to, as you said in the last segment, how Dr. Du Bois saw those coming out of the 18th, 19th century leading to the 20th century, racism has been at the front of American society. And now in the 21st century, we're still having to deal with it. Now, that said, I think it's very important to reiterate that things have, of course, gotten much better. And I think if we had President Obama here as a threesome to talk about this, he would say, yeah, things have gotten better. But I think he would even recognize that racism is still very prevalent within our society today. We do have another person out there on the campaign that might falsely think that, oh, you know, everything is just fine today. If you just pull yourself up by the bootstrap, then everything will be okay. And I can, then that individual that's on the GOP campaign trail will say, well, I know a lot of other people that were very successful. And yeah, of course, you can always find those segments. But when you still see within the economic system disparities of fairness that's there in hiring practice and in graduate practice and graduate schools and getting CEO jobs and management jobs and see pictures with women are not there and people of other ethnic groups are not there, then you have to still see these measures of racism that has to be present within the society in which we live in.
In other words, I think somebody has said because we have a black president does not necessarily mean that racism, prejudice, and et cetera has simply disappeared.
Absolutely. And that's so true. And I think he would actually agree with that as well. But I think it is a measure of success when you can go into certain areas of our country and then you find people that gave strong support. But it doesn't mean that throughout the United States is still not present. For instance, if our Secretary of State Hillary Clinton had won the presidency, that would mean that that sexism has just been rid because she became president. And she's a very qualified person, as our president said. He just said he felt that he was much more qualified and he's done an excellent job. But sometimes with that prejudice, you can't see the excellent job that he is doing mm-hmm. because they can't get beyond the prejudice. Mm-hmm. And it's a very interesting phenomenon mm-hmm. to stand back and watch. And you know, I hope this will always be a historical type of show. And, mm-hmm. and we know that one of the dictators of the world mm-hmm. Went down just on yesterday mm-hmm. or to realize that. And today in the debate, they don't want to give mm-hmm. credit where credit is due mm-hmm. to the President of the United States mm-hmm. that was very much in the forefront of galvanizing these mm-hmm. types of movements and helping out in collaboration with other mm-hmm. countries. But they just can't get beyond the prejudice mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. of seeing a person that did that to say, touche, that job well done. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's there. And in the last segment, you asked about students, and I think mm-hmm. it's very important for them to recognize Good. That. And unlike this GOP Kane who feels like you're victimizing the victim to mm-hmm. talk about this, mm-hmm. it's enlightening for the dominant group to be able to understand the history of America mm-hmm. and for us to be able to dialogue about it without feeling bad about it because mm-hmm. it is in part
that's
it's a part of the
American
culture.
That's the way you get rid of racism and prejudice by communication. Would
that's
you say
right.
that that's an important element in terms of trying to dissipate some of the attitudes that folks might have toward each other by understanding some of those things?
Absolutely.